I'm Tim Dettmers, a fifth-year PhD student at the University of Washington. My advisor is Luke Zettlemoyer. My main focus is on large language models and making them more accessible so everybody, particularly those with the least computational resources, can use these large models. If you look at ChatGPT at GPT-4, that is sort of a glimpse of what very large models can do. But the problem with these large models is that they're large. You need lots and lots of memory, lots and lots of GPUs, and that makes it not very accessible. So recently we invented the technique QLoRA, and it's sort of a game change of enabling the fine-tuning of very large models. That means you can not only take a large model and use it, but now you can take it and make it your own. You can personalize it, you can fine-tune it on your data. And this is very powerful. We use 4 bits, so 4 bits only has 16 different values, which means each weight in the neural network, which usually has 2 billion different values possibilities, now only has 16 different possibilities which value it can take. So we can now personalize 16 times larger models. And so what we ended up is we created a model that we call a Wanako. It's similar to ChatGPT. It's a raw model fine-tuned to follow your instructions. And so what we found is that our system is 97% as good as ChatGPT. And so this is really a sort of the change that we enabled. If you create scientific instruments that allow you to more efficient experimentations, you can use it to get more precise results, more results, and make faster progress. Research computing at the University of Washington is just a game changer. We need so much computational resources in our research, and we have here excellent computing infrastructure. We have the Hyak supercomputer, a GPU cluster with 600 GPUs. With that, we could do so many experiments. We could figure out things so quickly, get very reliable data, and we know where we needed to go. And it's just a very nice collaborative environment. And that's very open. People, machine learning, natural language processing, and systems work closely together. And so you can get advice from all these people. And with that, we could make rapid progress on this project. And that was just critical. It feels like everyone all around is excited. Researchers can do more research. People that just want to try and learn to work with language models, they can now do it on the gaming GPUs. And companies, now they can do more with the resources that they have. And so people are excited in all kinds of different directions. Mobile devices, companies, researchers, and just your everyday person that wants to use language models.